Welcome back to Yokohama, day two at the annual meeting of the Asian Development Bank. The Philippines remains one of the fastest growing countries in Southeast Asia, and I'm here today joined by Ernesto Pernia, Secretary of Socioeconomic Planning of the Philippines.
Yes.
Secretary, thank you for being with us.
Thank you for having me here.
The President Rodrigo Duterte announced his 10-point socioeconomic agenda when he was elected. One of the key issues in its agenda, but in the Philippines as a whole, is infrastructure development.
Yes.
Why is this government going to be successful where so many other governments have failed?
Well, it's because it's based on a plan, not only a medium-term plan, but even a long-term plan up to 2040. We have a medium-term plan at 2017-2022, but then this is extended actually up to 2040 for the long-term plan, which would mean three additional medium-term plans after the current medium-term plan.
So what are the key priorities there in terms of infrastructure investment?
The main thrust of the government now is to develop the country outside the national capital region, which is Metro Manila, which is already congested. And most of the infrastructure projects we are planning, and which are going to be, many of which will be implemented starting this year, will be in the regions. In the Visayas, the middle part of the country, and then Mindanao, which is the southern part of the country, as well as Luzon, the northern part of Luzon, which is also less developed than areas in and around Metro Manila.
So in terms of delivery of implementation of these plans, infrastructure plans or big infrastructure projects, what is going to be the key to success, to make them really happen?
Well, we have, as I've said, we have these infrastructure projects are based on a plan, on a deliberate plan, as well as we have a timetable for the different stages of getting the infrastructure projects implemented, approved first, and then, well, of course, feasibility studies, and then analysis, economic analysis of the economic viability of the projects, and then approval by the board, national, it's called NEDA Board, National Economic and Development Authority Board, which is chaired by the President, and I'm the Vice Chairman of that. And then it gets to the implementing agencies, the Department of Transportation, the Department of Public Works and Highways, Department of Energy, Department of Information and Communication Technology. So those are the main implementing projects. And all these different stages of the projects are already well spelled out.
So overall, you see a better structure for a better delivery and governance of the project. Another key feature of President Duterte's strategy has been the rebalancing, the pivot towards Asia. What does this mean in terms of trade and investment? We are already seeing growing investment and trade flows with the other Asian countries, South Korea, China.
Right.
But at the same time, investment, for example, from the U.S. is decreasing. These are the latest figures from the central bank. So what does this overall strategy mean in terms of trade and investment?
The rebalancing of the economy is really meant to diversify the partners in terms of trade, as well as the partners in terms of where investments will be coming from, foreign direct investment. So the more partners we have, the better for the country in terms of diversification of sources of trade and investment, so that when some countries fail or are in recession or slower economic growth, then we can, the other countries will be there and to take up the slack.
But no separation from the
US? No, definitely not separation. In fact, there has been a warming of relations with the US now.
Despite the initial headaches?
Yes, because, well, that was some kind of a reaction of the president to the practically a scolding, an admonition from the former president, Obama. Yeah, he was so critical of the president, very directly critical, and I guess he was offended by that.
The very last point, the Philippines is growing fast, it's growing quickly, but it remains a very unequal society.
Ah, yes.
So how are you guys going to try to make this economic development more inclusive?
Yes. Actually, you said that we are one of the fastest growing economies in Southeast Asia. Actually, it's not only in Asia as a whole, but even the world in terms of economic, one of the fastest rising economies in the world at 7% thereabouts last year. And then that is also going to be more or less the performance this year. Okay, in terms of, you know, the inequality problem, precisely the concentration of economic policy now, economic strategy, and which includes the location of infrastructure projects will be outside Metro Manila, will be in the regions, in the lagging regions, in the rural areas, including agriculture, because that is where there is need for economic life, economic vibrancy, employment generation is needed there.
So you really see this infrastructure as the missing link.
Yes.
Will eventually enable also part of the society, Filipino society, to be more in, more participant of this economic.
That's right. Essentially, getting these outlying regions into the mainstream of the economy, of the economic. Of the economic dynamo, which is, you know, which as of now is still centralized in the national capital region.
Secretary Pernia, thank you very much for being with us today.
Thank you too for this interview. Yeah.